Hello, everyone. This is Andreas Pop Culture Guy. Today is the latest Andreas Pop Culture Retrospective slash review, and it's on Dawn of the Planet of the Apes for its 10th anniversary. Now, Dawn of the Planet of the Apes is the 2014 film, a direct sequel to the reboot, The Rise of the Planet of the Apes, back in 2011. It's directed by Matt Reeves, and stars Andy Serkis, Gary Oldman, Jason Clarke, Kerry Russell, and Kelly Smith C, and Toby Cable. Now, as everyone knows, Dawn of the Planet of the Apes is a fantastic sequel to The Rise of the Planet of the Apes, with its stunning special effects sequences and its in exploring the recurring philosophy and ethical issues involving war and peace, trust and betrayal, and the spiritual nature of leadership in times of chaos and disruption. Dawn of the Planet of the Apes paid homage to the origin story while creating a sophisticated story that brought something fresh into the series of the Planet of the Apes. Dawn of the Planet of the Apes did a great job of exposing the worst tendencies of mankind while still being an exciting blockbuster, which is a very impressive feat. Dawn of the Planet of the Apes tells an entirely original story and demonstrates a proficient but engaging action spectacle, emotional drama, and thought-provoking ideas. Now, as I did before, I think this sequel, Dawn of the Planet of the Apes, raises the bar for the franchise altogether under new guidance from director Matt Reeves, far surpassing expectations. That's both a fun, so much spectacle and a powerful statement piece. Matt Reeves raises the bar even further with Dawn of the Planet of the Apes when he takes over the Planet of the Apes franchise, in large, with the second and third one coming with the redo. Upping the stakes, bringing a greater level of emotional sophistication to the narrative, the film throws and flies into these compelling characters, particularly Caesar, the leader of the ape colony, mainly portrayed again by the motion capture mastermind Andy Serkis. Caesar's internal struggle between his loyalty to his own kind and Caesar, and his desire for peace with the humans adds layers of complexity to the narrative. Furthermore, main villain Koba as well is also well written as Caesar, and he's honestly the best thing and favorite character in this movie for me. The opposite happened to Koba. Humans abuse Koba in the lab, and he has scars show the abuse he went through. The many years he had the virus affected the humanity. This makes him aggressive and mistrustful of the humans, but it also gives him a valid reason for being aggressive and mistrustful toward humans as well. He's not pure evil. He's been hurt, and this makes his motivation unsustainable, which makes it great film overall. And this also helps contrast between Caesar and Koba so well and brutally playing out in the film. Both wanted to do what they think is best for the apes and going about it in different ways. Caesar, who wants peace because of his love for the humans, and Koba, who wants war because of his hatred for them. The Planet of the Apes films are in class of their own. However, what truly sets the Dawn of the Planet of the Apes apart is a thought-provoking exploration of mentality and the nature of humanity. As the conflict escalates, both humans and apes are forced to confront their own prejudice and preconceptions between each other, ultimately raising the question about who the true villains are in this battle for survival. Now, in conclusion, for the Dawn of the Planet of the Apes review, it's a masterpiece of modern cinema, combining stunning visuals, compelling storytelling, thought-provoking themes. Either you're a fan of the original franchise or the new to the series, this film is a must-see and looking for a truly unforgettable cinematic experience. I was unfortunate to see this film in theaters, and it's still great after 10 years. Plus, Dawn of the Planet of the Apes has far more human drama than the usual modern max-driven blockbusters back then and now. While never compromising its action and through the scenes. Dawn of the Planet of the Apes is still regarded today as one of the best movies in the Planet of the Apes franchise and ranks among some of the best science fiction sequels in history, which I what helps it is because a great director like Matt Reeves that makes Dawn as a aesthetically entirely distinct from what life with Michael Haise Sargent cinematography, and hence the camera work pointing from the striking dank palette, and then with the music by Michael Giacchino, Haise Carli, embellish the score that occasionally evoke the grandeur of Kurosawa's work on the Lord of the Rings. True. In addition to that, also to the great cast, as I mentioned, we have Andy Serkis, Toby Cable, Jason Clarke, Kerry Russell, Kerry Russell, and Cody McPhee, and Gary Oldman. Dawn of the Planet of the Apes is a prime example of the franchise film going above and beyond to deliver a cinematic experience unlike any other, with heavy themes of war, bitterness, what it means to be human. And that will be my conclusion to this review of Dawn of the Planet of the Apes. Happy 10th anniversary, Planet of the Apes, Dawn. You're one of the best sequels I ever seen. Last 10 years. It's amazing. And in my personal favorite, because it's the timeline of my dad. It was no longer with me. I think this is one of the best films I've seen with my dad with, and I think I will cherish it forever. Happy 10th anniversary, Dawn. And thank you, everyone, for listening to this latest retrospective slash review, and there's more to come. Thank you, and see you soon. Ciao.